All right. So next, our next speaker is an openly transgender veteran, a foster father, an activist, and I'm truly happy to have him here to learn more about him because I like to gain friends. So I'm hoping I can gain another friend in Mr. J. Potter.
Hi, everyone. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Jay. I'm an intersex, transmasculine, queer veteran, and now foster father who moved to Providence for a 6-month stint 8.5 years ago. I love this community, this is my home, and these are my people. This Pride Month hits differently. It's post-pandemic, it's post-Trump, and I'm currently watching trans healthcare attacked at a rate that is unheard of. I want to publicly say there is zero evidence of trans people having advantages in sports, and my people, myself included, deserve equitable health care. If your biggest concern is taking away a trans child's rights to play sports, I feel pity for the lack of depth in your heart for your fellow man, for your lack of understanding, but most of all, for your lack of unbridled privilege that you feel so threatened by innocent children wanting to play sports. Speaking of children, the real reason why I wanted to speak to you today is I'm a foster father for DCYF Rhode Island with the expressed intent of caring for our community, the LGBTQ community in Providence, Rhode Island. Today, my house looks radically different than it did a month ago. Being young and queer, foster children express fear of coming out. Multiple homes turn them away. And in cases of being with a sibling, they get separated. Families, especially religious ones, refuse to care for young gay boys. They refuse to care for gender non-conforming teens. They refuse to care for lesbians at an unprecedented rate. When families do bring kids into their homes, these kids are often met with uneducated and unsupportive environments where they cannot thrive. I desperately want that to stop in Providence, Rhode Island. My kids smile, they laugh, they sing, they're doing well in school, but most of all, they are loved and they are supported for exactly who they are. We have the gayest house in all of the land, and I wouldn't change a single thing. We have a revolving door of kids who know, whoever they are and whoever they love, that they are welcome here, that they have a hot meal, that they have a warm blanket. They have a safe place to exist in this often hate-filled world. Even when I'm trying to figure out linear equations at 2 a.m. or figure out how 2 children produce so much laundry, quite literally, I'm honored to do the work with them and for them to make this place, Providence, a place worth fighting for. These kids, my kids included, deserve better from our community. Why? Because they are watching you. They are waiting for it to be safe for themselves. In our community, foster children, they need the love and support of their elders. Our community needs to step up and take care of their own. A Gucci rainbow purse, it does not impress me. You love Pride? Don't spend your money at a big box store on a rainbow t-shirt. Mentor a young gay kid who has no support, a homeless trans teen, a butch non-binary youth, be an emergency placement home, a foster home, offer respite care for queer kids, be a mentee, help your local GSA, give these kids someone to admire. Yeah. I have to turn down LGBTQ kids in terrible situations on a weekly basis because my house is full. And it breaks my heart every single time I get a phone call about a kid who's trans and homeless in Providence, and I don't have the space to take them in, I lose hope. I am speaking today to ask this community to put their heart and their money where their mouth is. Be a resource to an LGBT youth in need. And state specifically, you will accept LGBTQ youth of color. Fight for the rights of those in our community that are forgotten. These kids are our people. Let's leave a community behind to be proud of. If people can choose hate, I can choose love. I love you. I love this community. And I love these kids. Nothing about us without us. We deserve a seat at every table in this great nation. Trans veterans, we fought for your rights. Don't forget about ours. I still can't join the military today. LGBTQ foster kids are the children of this community. They are our future. Let's recognize our power and take care of them. I leave you with a quote from Talmud on this Shabbat. Do not be daunted by the enormity of the world's grief. Do justly now. Love now. Walk humbly now. You are not obligated to complete the work, but neither are you free to abandon it. Shabbat Shalom and happy Pride Month. Thank you.
That was beautiful.